Dear students, today we will be studying ultrafiltration plant, tubular kind. So here, this is the control panel of the plant and it is starting from here. This is the balance tank. So this is the main balance tank. At the bottom of this balance tank, we can see a pipeline connected via that valve is going to this pump. So this is a lobe type pump, a positive displacement pump. It will be circulating, it will be giving its outlet at this end, and we are having this air vessel here. So this air vessel is for control of, the fluctuations, and via that filter, it will be coming to this pipeline here. So here we are having two membranes in parallel. So here we can see this is the one of the membrane module and this is the another membrane module. Both of these membrane modules are merged into a common suction line from this bottom. So this pipeline connected via this pump to this membrane module and directly to this first membrane module. So this is the first membrane module. It is its pressure connection. This is the temperature gauge. And for another membrane module, we are required to use one more pump because of loss of pressure. So one pump will not be sufficient. So it will be acting as a booster pump. So at this membrane, this is the permeate outlet. So permeate outlet is made common from this side to both these membranes and from top side also. This is the permeate outlet here and this is common with another permeate of that membrane. In between we are having a tubular kind of heat exchanger. So those two flexible pipelines we can see, they are from the heat exchanger. So those two pipelines are from heat exchanger and one pipeline emerging from the top, that is from the retentate side. So this retentate side pipeline is coming via this line, getting a U-turn. This is a sampling box here, and via this valve we can control the flow rate. So here we are seeing VR1, so R for retentate. So this is valve for retentate 1. This is VP1, valve for permeate 1, and this is VP2. So this is for permeate 2. Here we are having two flow meters. So FP1, FW. FP1, P for product and W for water. So water, while we are in CIP or cleaning cycle, then flux rates are high. So here we can see this is the flux meter in liters per hour. So this is up to 1000, and this another meter, flux meter, also in liters per hour, this is up to 100. So in the case of product flow, the flux are slow, less, and hence this flux gauge will be used, and in the case of CIP, the flux are high, so this gauge will be used. And these are the pressure gauges. So it measures transmembrane pressure, this first one, and these two gauges, M1 and M2, are for the pressure of the outlet of pumps. So during its working, for this particular plant, we are required to set the pressure according to the standard operating procedures or protocols. And these are the on-off switches of those pumps. So